In our previous video, we built an adder that can compute 1 plus 1 and 1 plus 0. If we build a subtractor, we need new wirings for sure. The trick we're going to use here is use adder to do subtraction to avoid new wirings. How to do that? Here's a hint. In our base 10 system, we know that 64 minus 38 is 26. Now we're asking, what number, when added to 64, will give us 26? That's impossible, unless it's negative. But then we're back to the original subtraction problem. How about we add number 62? We get 126. It's not the correct answer, but the correct answer is in here. What is this 62? It's the 100th complement of the original subtrahend. Why is that? If you think of doing the original subtraction and getting the answer first, then you add by 100. You will see that your original answer stays undisturbed while the highest position gets a bump. Let's be more general. Suppose we're subtracting 2 4-digit numbers. The symbols can take any values, but I'm using ABCD to be general. Say the answer looks like this. Now, if you add a 5-digit number with leading 1 and the rest all zeros, you know that the answer will be different only by a leading 1. What's interesting to note is, this complement method is base independent. So it works for whatever base you're in, base 10, base 4, base 2. The only difference is that these 1 and 4 zeros will represent a different quantity. So first that we need to calculate this complement. Then the result can be added to the minuend through the adder. And the final answer is contained in here. But then we have a problem. How do we calculate this complement? Sounds like we avoid a subtraction problem by creating a new one. But this one is way easier in the binary world. In base 2, possible symbols are either zeros or ones. Let's say we want to find the complement of 1101. This 1 and 4 zeros can be broken down into 1 and 4 ones. Because the minimum 5-bit number differs from max 4-bit number by 1. Hence, the complement problem is broken down into two problems, a subtraction problem and an addition problem. The subtraction problem is very easy. If you realize that the answer is simply the inversion of the subtrahend, that's easy to implement in circuit, as we will see shortly. Then you add a 1 to the inversion to get the complement. To summarize, say this is the original subtraction we want to solve, 12 minus 5. So when we hit these two inputs, they will be translated into high-low voltages in wires stored in the memory units we've talked about before. You first invert each bit of the subtrahend using one transistor, placing the resistor closer to the high voltage end and draw output from just below the resistor. Now a high voltage input will turn the transistor into a conductor. This lower end of the resistor will show a low voltage because it's connected to the low voltage end. So a high becomes a low. If the input is low, transistor remains an insulator. The output will show high voltage because it's connected to the high voltage end. Each bit can be inverted through an inverter. And this is the result. For simplicity, we will use inverter symbol. Then you add 1 to get the complement. Using the adder we built before, we get the complement. Then last step, you add the complement to the minuend. You will get your answer. But remember to ignore the highest bit. Take these lower bits. This kind of direct connection is easy to understand, but has serious problems. The inputs, whether original ones or intermediate ones, are always fed into the computing engine directly. So the use of the computing engine is only one time. For example, this adder can only compute the complement. To calculate the final result, we need a second adder. Imagine your problems involve successive computations. For example, adding for 100 times. It doesn't make sense to have 100 adders connected to each other. So from next video, we're going to explore the answer to this problem. The solution is to design the components and structure of a computer, giving users the freedom to reuse these basic computing modules in order to solve any complex problems. It will lead to the discussion of CPU architecture. You will understand what makes a computer a computer.